Now, this is going to be an interesting video because what I thought was true was absolutely not true. It was completely false. I thought one of the reasons why our foods were deficient in nutrients was because the soil was deficient in minerals. Okay, that's what I thought. But I recently found out that is absolutely not true. Our soils are not depleted of minerals. Okay. Interesting book, Environmental Soil Chemistry, second edition. It's like $105, very, very expensive textbook by Donald Sparks. This is what he found. He did soil samples around the world. Okay. He compiled all this data and he found that the concentration of minerals of an average sample of soil demonstrated plenty of nutrients. Okay. Now, this actually was a shocker. And I was like, at first, I'm like, this can't be. There's no way this could be. But let's go on. There's another document that I want to talk about. It was by Dr. David Johnson, and he's part of the Institute for Sustainable Agriculture Research. Okay. And he did some interesting research. He demonstrated that the soils with the highest nutrients did not predict the best plant growth. Another piece of information that I was actually quite surprised. You would think that if the soil has the most minerals, it would produce the best crop, right? Or the healthiest plant. That's absolutely not true. What he did find, which will explain everything, is this. The best predictor of plant growth and plant health was the fungal and bacteria ratio. You see, as you use the farmland and you use pesticides and insecticides, what happens over time is you lose the fungal growth until your bacterial counts become higher and higher and higher to the point where you're 100% bacteria and no fungal. You see, fungus is a very important part of soil. It's part of the microbial flora that helps break down the rocks, the sand, and the organic material, and then makes the minerals available to the plant. It's both the fungus and bacteria that make minerals soluble for the plant so it can be usable and exchangeable. And without those microorganisms, the minerals basically are locked up in the clay, in the sand, and the rocks. They're unavailable to the plant. And you need a ratio of 1:1, fungus to bacteria. And this is why a lot of farmers have to use NPK, the nitrogen, phosphorus, and potassium, because they can just give the plants, you know, some quick nutrients to get them to grow, because there's very little microbial growth that is making the rocks available for that plant. Now, how does this relate to our bodies? Well, we need microorganisms in our gut to assimilate food. We need acid in our stomach to actually help absorb the nutrients from the food, to break down the proteins. Without the acid, we can't absorb minerals. We can't break down protein into amino acids. Without bile salts, we can't extract fat-soluble vitamins. Without enzymes, we can't break down the food to extract the micronutrients. And without friendly fungus and friendly bacteria, we can't actually break down the food either to extract nutrients into our body. And so a big mistake that people make is they go to the store, they buy their one-a-day vitamin, and they're buying basically the wrong type of vitamins. They're buying inorganic elemental minerals, for example, things that are like rocks or metals, and our body cannot pull those in. See, our bodies were meant to consume the plants and the animals that have already converted these minerals into minerals that we can absorb in our body. And so this video is really just about emphasizing the importance of the microorganisms, not just in our body, but in the soil that actually makes the food that animals eat to make us healthier. So stay tuned for more videos on this very interesting topic. Hey, before you go real quick, I have a course entitled How to Bulletproof Your Immune System. It's a free course. I want you to take it. And here's why. Here's you.
Here is your environment. Everyone is focused on this over here, avoiding your environment. But what about here? What about strengthening your immune system? That's what's missing. This course will show you how to bulletproof yourself, and so you can tolerate and resist your environment much better by strengthening your own immune system. I put a link down in the description right down below. Check it out and get signed up today.